Hello everybody, welcome to the Python Math Project section. In this video, I'm going to discuss the Egyptian multiplication approach. In this approach, we want to find out a times b, where a and b are positive integers. The idea of this multiplication approach is like this. We start with 1, and then I get the powers of 2, until the number is just smaller than a, which is the first number in my multiplication. At the same time, I multiply the second number, which is called b, by 2, when I get the powers. And here comes the important step. I need to choose the powers of 2 that can help me sum up to the first number, which is called a. And then, after finding out those powers, I can add the corresponding multiples of b to get the answer to a times b, which is our goal. So let us see an example. Suppose I want to do multiplication as follows. 22 times 41. Now the first number is called a, which is 22, and the second one is b, which is 41. And in the first step, I have to start with 1 in my first column, and at the same time, I start with b, which is 41, in my second column. And then I have to do the doubling of the previous number in each of the columns. So number 1 becomes number 2 in the first column, and when I multiply 41 in the second column by 2, I would get 82. And then I do the doubling of the previous number in each of the columns. So 2 becomes 4, and at the same time, 82 becomes 164. So on and so forth. And then I would have 16 in my first column, and 656 in the second column after the doubling process. Will I continue to do the doubling? No. Because when I want to double 16, I would have 32, which is actually larger than the value of a, which is just 22. So I would stop the doubling if the next double of the first number is greater than a. So in this case, I would stop at 16. After finding out those doubled values in each of the columns, I want to figure out which of the powers of 2 can help me sum up to the value of a, which is 22. And I find that 16 plus 4 plus 2 is equal to 22. So now I have 3 rows with an arrow. And in this case, I just add up the corresponding values in the second column. So I would have 82 plus 164 plus 656. So altogether, I would have 902 as the answer to the product of 22 times 41. So now I want to implement the Egyptian multiplication using Python. So I have to mention the two numbers to be multiplied first. So the first number is 45 and the other number is 72. And then the next step is to generate the two columns mentioned in the previous slides. So we can remember that the first column starts with 1 and the second column starts with the value of b, which is the second number to be multiplied. Now in this case, it is just equal to 72. And then I want to build up both columns starting with these two numbers. Now we have to remember that we don't build up the two columns indefinitely. What is the condition to stop the building? We have to make sure that the final number in the first column has to be just smaller than the first number, which is 45 in my case. So if this condition happens, I have to break the while loop and discontinue my building of the two columns. And then if that condition doesn't hold, I can do the build-up. Okay, my idea is to build up the following elements by using the previous element in each of the columns. So here, you can see that the index is just minus 1. In Python, when we mention the index as minus 1, it just means that the counting will start from the rightmost element in your list. So in this case, I would always keep finding out the last element or the bottommost element in my columns. After building up the two columns, I can make a table to show the column elements. Now this is the first line to show the two values to do the multiplication. In my case, it would be 45 times 72. Okay, the table is going to list the column elements. So now I would like to do the for loop for a number of times indicated by the number of elements in the columns. I can choose either column 1 or column 2 to do this task. And then I want to show the column elements from the beginning of the lists. And this print command is just going to give me a new line. And after that, I'm going to do the selection of the rows, which can be done as follows. Okay, now I set up two variables first. The first variable called remaining number 1 is going to help me determine the powers of 2 that can sum up to the value of number 1, which is the first number to be multiplied. And of course, the variable called answer is going to store the intermediate results from column 2 that can help me to evaluate the product. And I'm going to explain the use of these two variables later on. And let me continue to do the process. And my approach to find out the powers of 2 is from the last element of column 1 to the first element of column 1. So now the variable I is going to find out the elements from the bottom of the column to the top of the column. So you can see that this one corresponds to the starting index, and this one corresponds to the ending index, which is minus 1. And here the step size is minus 1. That means I go from the right hand side to the left hand side. So when I have this setup, I'm able to start with the rightmost element of the list, and then I would go to the left one by one until I would be able to reach the leftmost element in my list. Okay, now I'm going to pick up the powers of 2 that can help me sum up to number 1. Okay, these two printing actions are trying to show the role to take in each of my steps. So now the variable r is going to collect the powers of 2 from the largest possible one to the smallest possible one that can help me sum to number 1. So the value of I would be decreasing. And then I'm able to pick up that row, and I'm able to show the corresponding value in column 2. And after picking up the corresponding value in column 2, I need to really store that intermediate value in my answer variable. So now I'm going to handle the two variables mentioned beforehand. Now you can see that the answer variable is trying to store the values in column 2 so that I'm able to get the corresponding partial values that can help me sum up to the product of A times B, or number 1 times number 2. And you can see that the variable called remaining number 1 is decreased by the amount obtained in the ith element of column 1. That means when I want to pick up the largest possible power of 2, I need to deduct it from the number 1. And then when I continue this process, I'm able to get all the powers of 2 that can help me sum up to number 1. Okay, I have to print out the answer at the end. Okay, I have to type something more here. This should be column 1 instead of just column. Okay, so I can just correct my typo. And now let us see the result of the program. Okay, I can find that I have a typo here. This should be column 2, so I want to update column 2 by multiplying the final element of my list by 2. So let me try to play with it. Okay, you can see that the first number is 45 and the second number is 72. And the first column starts with 1 and the second column starts with number 2. And then using this while loop, I'm able to continue the doubling. So I will have 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and 32. And at the same time, the second column would be 72, 144, and so on. So, is it possible for me to multiply 32 by 2 so that I get 64? It is not allowed because it will violate the condition shown here. That means if it is possible that the multiple of 2 is larger than the first number, I will just stop the doubling. Okay, and then the table is complete. And now I would like to pick up the rows that can help me get the product. The idea is to find out the powers of 2 from the first column so that I can sum up to 45. So how can I do it? You can see that I can pick up 4 numbers from the first column. These 4 numbers would sum up to 45. So how can I pick them up? I start with the very last value in the first column, which is just the final element in the column 1 list. And then I would like to find out the remaining numbers that can help me sum up to 45. So 45 minus 32 would be just 13. So 13 is actually smaller than 16. So in this case, 16 is no longer possible to be included in the sum, because 32 times 16 is 48. It is already beyond 45, so I won't choose 16. So when I have 13 remaining, I would try to obtain the largest possible power of 2, which is 8. And after that, I deduct 8 from 13, so I will have 5 remaining. And the value of 5 is actually larger than 4, so I can still pick up 4 in my next step. And after that, I deduct 4 from 5, so that I have 1. Since 2 is larger than 1, I'm not able to pick up 2 in my solution, so I can just pick up the final value of the first column, which is 1. The final value here corresponds to the leftmost element in the column 1 list. So at the same time, I can just remember the value from the column 2, so I just add up these 4 values to become the answer of the multiplication. So the sum is just that answer, and that value is just a product of 45 times 72. So you can see that the idea is to build up the 2 columns. That is the approach used in the previous slides. And by using this for loop, I'm able to pick up the powers of 2 that can help me sum up to the first number. And at the same time, I remember the corresponding values in the second column. And I just add them up to get the sum. And the sum is just equal to the product. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.